just because it's in print doesn't mean it's the gospel. People write negative things because they feel that's what sells. Good news to them doesn't sell. One time I asked to use the restroom, and they said, sure, it's right around the corner there. Once I went in the restroom, they locked me in there for like 45 minutes. There was doo-doo, feces thrown all over the walls, the floor, the ceiling, and it stunk so bad. Then one of the policemen came by the window and he made a sarcastic remark. He said, "Smell? Does it smell good enough for you in there? How do you like the smell? Is it good?" And I just simply said, "It's all right. It's okay." So I just sat there and waited.
For 45 minutes?
Yeah, for 45 minutes, about 45 minutes. And then one cop would come by and say, "Oh, you'll be out in a second. You'll be out in a second." Then there would be another 10 minutes added on, then another 15 minutes added on. They did this on purpose.
And I'm going to quote here. "Why can't you share your bed? The most loving thing to do is to share your bed with someone."
Yes.
As we sit here today, do you still think that it's acceptable to share your bed with children?
Of course. Of course. Why not? If you're going to be a pedophile, if you're going to be Jack the Ripper, if you're going to be a murderer, it's not a good idea. That I'm not. That's how we were raised. And I didn't sleep in the bed with the child. Even if I did, it's okay. I slept on the floor. I gave the bed to the child. I would never stop helping and loving people the way Jesus said to. He said, continue to love, always love, bring on the children, imitate the children, not childish, but childlike. Well, what's wrong with sharing your bed? I didn't say I slept in the bed. Even if I did sleep in the bed, it's okay. I am not going to do anything sexual to a child. It's not where my heart is. I will slip my wrist first. I would never do anything like that. But that's not Michael Jackson, I'm sorry. That's someone else.
How has it impacted, touring, record sales?
My album's number one all over the world. All over the world. America's the only one because, I don't want to say too much.
But it's not number one in the United States.
It's a conspiracy, yeah. I don't want to say too much. I'm done.
Michael, what would you say to your fans who have supported you through all of this and who today, some of them might have questions? What would you say to them?
Well, I would tell them I love them very much. And they've learned about me and know about me from a distance. But if you really want to know about me, there's a song I wrote, which is the most honest song I've ever written. It's the most autobiographical song I've ever written. It's called Childhood.
Have you seen my childhood?
They should listen to it. That's the one they really should listen to.
Before you judge me, try hard to love me.
And thank you for your support, the fans around the world. I love you with all my heart.
The pain.
I don't take any of it for granted, any of it. And I love them dearly, all over the world.